Lisa, we have disassembled your transmission and laid the parts out here to inspect for damage. And I'll show you what we found on your transmission. First off, right here, these are called roller bearings because these roll, and you can see this bearing's bad. There's also another one I'm going to show you. It's much worse than that one, but you can see how maybe it created a domino effect. And in here, these clutches are supposed to be a tan color. You can see how black they are from the heat. That one's worn just a little bit, and you can see how these are not worn. These are completely burned black, and you can see how it's just really, really got hot and was scraping. So that's where you're having a problem there. And this is another roller bearing, and you can see these are completely, it came right out and that bearing's shot. And right here, it's hard to see the camera, but along here, that is supposed to be a smooth race. A race is simply where a flat is putting against it a bearing, and it's not. It's wore out and it's shot. And what's happened in here is you got three of these in here. Two of them are good. You got that one's okay and that one's okay, but we have the same problem on the space. If you can see that ring around there, it may be difficult to see, but that's wore, and that's going to need to be replaced also. And with the contaminated fluid, you have these pressure switches that are, these are contaminated and will have to be replaced. Inside your torque converter is fluid, and that fluid is now contaminated, and we can't change the fluid out because there's only one hole, so it's impossible to get all the fluid out of there, so we don't want any particular, so that torque converter is going to need to be replaced with a new torque converter. And with that said, we also need to flush out the cooling system, that portion of your transmission, because it has contaminated fluid in it also. We're going to use our hot flush machine and get that all cleared out there for you. I'm going to put together an estimate for parts and labor, and you'll get that along with the email that has this video link, and we'll get you taken care of. Thanks, Lisa.
Okay, this is our hot flush machine, and it's not hooked up to your car, but it's going to be, and this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. That runs over there to the lift. And then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does, this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now, it's only at about 179 degrees. But it'll get up to 190, and we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it. And it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second, it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now, this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now, it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now, this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute is what that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. Let's see if I get a better shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. And this is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. That's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.